Witness testimony got underway today in the federal trial against Tony Alamo. He's accused of taking young girls across state lines for sex. 4029's Damon Maloney was in the courthouse in Texarkana, where a witness described the evangelist as a dictator who controlled their lives.
Today here in Texarkana, jurors heard from two witnesses, former members of the Tony Alamo Ministries. One of those witnesses was 30-year-old Jeanette Orlando. She told the jury that she was forced to marry Tony Alamo at the age of 15, and that is when the two began having sex. The first day of witness testimony brought out raw emotions from Orlando as she recounted her teenage years as Alamo's wife and her efforts to leave the ministry. She testified that Alamo had several underage wives, including an 8-year-old. At the heart of the case, Orlando told the jury she traveled with Alamo to Tennessee in 1994, and there the two had sex. Claudia Koshengrove, a former Alamo follower, says she came to Wednesday's proceedings as a sign of support for those hurt under Tony Alamo.
Now I really want to see justice done to Tony Alamo, because I see these girls who have been so abused by him, sexually abused and physically abused and mentally abused, spiritually, every kind of way.
Alamo's defense team objected several times to the relevancy of Orlando's testimony, hammering away at her credibility, asking her why she was unclear as to what she told federal agents during interviews last year about Alamo and out-of-state travel.
Oh, they just smearing him. They're presenting all his relationships with adult women and who lives in the house and all that sort of thing.
The defense says the out-of-state travel was for church business purposes. Prosecutors say Alamo has a pattern of marrying and having sex with underage girls, something the jury will soon have the final say on. Reporting in Texarkana, Damon Maloney, 4029 News.
On the stand, Orlando cried when she talked about the day in 2006 she left the ministry. She says it took her up to 2 years to build up the courage to talk to FBI agents about her experiences. The trial resumes tomorrow morning.